Hello, everybody. Gwenga Latunji here. Oftentimes, we must have studied before we say we want to write an exam. But we find ourselves still failing the exam, especially professional exams that we know that they are tough. We must have read, but we still find ourselves failing as students, and we ask the question, why, and I've read what has happened. So I want to deal with an observed issue. Why do students fail? We need to answer the question, how to understand keywords, and the answer lies in understanding the keywords in exams questions. To chart our path to exam success and successes, answering correctly what the examiner actually had in mind when they were asking the question. That is what we want to deal with. And I believe this is going to help us, further us to speed up the success rate in our exams. So, oftentimes we find ourselves in the exams and they are asking questions. Questions like, define, explain. Questions like, identify, describe, distinguish, compare and contrast, analyze, assess. We find ourselves being asked to examine. We find ourselves being asked to discuss, explore, criticize, evaluate, critically evaluate, construct the case, recommend. All these words, oftentimes we get used to the way we use them naturally, but oftentimes in exams, they actually meant they have deeper meaning. Oftentimes they have deeper meaning, and as students, we need to pay attention to those keywords. So let us examine them one after the other. When we are asked to define something, it means let us know the meaning. What is the meaning of this? So we must be able to tell us the meaning of it in defining it. When we are asked to explain, and we are going from most basic to the complicated, when we are asked to explain, make clear, ensure you make clear to the examiner what you think about the question asked. This is germane. This is very important to do that when we are asked the question of explain. If you can quickly define it too, it's okay. But explain, ensure that you clarify that particular question, make it clear. Then when we are asked to identify is like saying isolate. Identify. So must ensure we make a selection of series of items, recognize them in their natural self as items in the exam. Select the most appropriate. So when we're asked to identify, it means we should recognize them in their natural state, and we should make a selection of them. We may be equally asked in the exams to describe. So now when we're asked to describe, let's say for example, somebody asks us outside the examination hall, please describe this location for me. What comes to our mind? Details comes to mind. So when we are asked to describe, ensure you give detailed features of that particular question. Ensure you give detailed feature of that particular question that has been asked. Then we may be asked to distinguish between so and so. So when we are asked to distinguish, it's becoming elaborate now. Ensure, because before you can distinguish, we must know it. What do you want to distinguish? So ensure you make a defined clarity of the items, two or three items thereabouts that you've been given to distinguish between. So let us know them. Let us know their feature. Define the different terms. Let us know your viewpoints and what are their concepts. So you must conceptualize before you can answer this question. Let us know from what concepts do you want to talk about. Make it basic first of all. Make it basic in their feature. Then let us know their differences. Let us know their differences. So for us to be able to pass a question that asks us to distinguish, must be able to give the meaning, must be able to give the feature. So more or less, when we are talking about distinguish, you are answering the question of define. You are answering the question of describe. Then you are asking the question of making your opinion known, conceptualize the difference between the two or the three, depending on how many items you are given to differentiate or to distinguish. So that is when you are asked to distinguish. Then you may be asked to compare and contrast. When you are asked to compare and contrast, what does that mean? To compare and to contrast. Explain the similarity and differences between the items or the terms, your viewpoint and your concept about it. So for and against, what are their strengths? What are their weaknesses? What are the advantages? What are the disadvantages? Where and when can we use them together? When and where do we need to actually isolate them and apply them case by case? So we are comparing and you are contrasting. But when you are asked specifically to contrast in the question, it means explain the difference between the two terms. Make your concept and your viewpoints known. So just give us the difference and you are good to go. Then we are asked to analyze. You must give your reason for the current situation or what has happened. So you must be able to go deeper. Give us figures. Marshal your points. How did you arrive at the basis of your conclusion? Analyze it. Like when we are talking about analysis, you know, we'll be talking about following the trend, comparison, you're analyzing. To follow the trend, you must have, or you must have built your points. You must have your figures correctly. Comparing, maybe comparing year on year or the like, or quarter on quarter and the like. So you must be able to look into the situation critically and bring meaningful discussion out of it. And in bringing meaningful discussion out of it, you must be clear about why you believe this is so. It must be convincing. So that means you must have your figures correctly. You must have your position correctly before you can score good mark in analysis. Then when we are asked to assess a situation, assess in a particular question, it's talking about determining the strength, the weaknesses, the importance, significance and ability of that particular contributor in the question. That is what it means when we are asked to assess. And when you want to assess, you must equally make your opinion known about it when you carry out an assessment. This may even be in form of a report writing question. So you must have your objective and you must have your conclusion when you've done an assessment correctly. Okay, we may equally be asked to examine. So when we are asked to examine, simply put, we are being asked to critically review in details. To critically review in details. So when you are examining a question, just like when you are being examined, you are given a detailed hours of examination, rather. You are given full 3, 2.5 hours and the like. So that is detail. Likewise, you must be detailing your answers in that particular exam. So you go full-fledged in answer to questions that ask for examining or ask that you examine. So you must be conscious of time too when you are asked to examine, but ensure you go full detail as fast as possible within the time limit you are having. Then you are asked to discuss. When we are asked to discuss, it's just like when we are having a discussion between friends. You make your case, make your argument for and against, but ensure you are able to support your argument. It's important that you are able to support your argument. Don't give baseless arguments in examination. Support your argument correctly and you'll be good to go. When we ask to explore, exploration question, just like people in expedition, examine and discuss in a wide range manner. So explore and discuss, they are a bit similar, but when you are exploring, you must go more into details. I want to believe you know that you are exploring. Some people explore for the rest of their life. That is exploring. The researchers are explorers. Apart from people that go maybe to galaxy, astronauts. So when we explore, it's a wide range. So you will go more deeper in exploring question. So for somebody to pass an explorative question, now somebody must know that that particular topic, you read it back to back. You must have read it back to back for you to answer question on explore, because you must go in full detail. Then when we are asked to criticize, we may be asked to criticize. So present the weaknesses, the problems of or in that particular question. Make your viewpoints known and ensure you support your position with evidence. Ensure you support your argument with evidence. So it must not be baseless when you are criticizing. And it will be good when you are criticizing to show a bit of the positive side of things too. But when you are criticizing, make your viewpoint known. Explore as much as possible the weaknesses and the problems observed. Give solution as short as possible, but explore the weaknesses. Then when we are asked to evaluate or critically evaluate, it means that we should determine the value of something in the light of a constructive argument for and against. For and against, you are evaluating. When you are evaluating, you go deeper in your argument for and against. So it's a very deep verb in examination. So when you are evaluating, ensure that your contribution, let's say for example, you are to evaluate the question like this: director's contribution in an organization. So when you are to evaluate, why do we need to have directors or board of directors? So you must ensure you go in full detail and also give us the strengths, the weaknesses, the advantages, the disadvantages, a solution and how to manage the situation. So you must determine the value in the light of the argument for and against. So you may go in a route like the independent directors, ordinarily we don't need them, or you may say we need them. But when you say, either way, you must support your argument. You may be asked to construct a case. When you have to construct a case, you are like a legal advisor. Build up a case for an argument. So you need to present the argument in favor or against. And you must ensure you support your argument with facts and figures. Support your argument with facts and figures. Last but not the least, we may be asked to recommend. Maybe asked to recommend. When we're asked to recommend, we are serving in an advisory capacity. So advise the appropriate actions to pursue in time that the recipient. Now, the recipient is your examiner, we understand. So when we recommend, we must speak as much as possible in plain language, in a way that the user of the information will understand. So by the time we are recommending, we are already concluding on a project. We've explored, must have distinguished, we must have analyzed, we must have assessed, we must have examined, must have discussed. Then we are making recommendation. make it plain language. Don't go for the jargons in the profession by the time you are recommending. Make it straight to the point, as detailed as possible, as comprehensible as possible, and acknowledge your recipient. Oftentimes when a question of recommendation comes, maybe in a case study and the like, when we are recommending, a lot must have gone ahead. Like I said, we must have our objective, we must have built up an argument, we must have analyzed to support our recommendation so that it will not be baseless. I want to believe that understanding keywords in exams will not only ensure we pass, it will equally ensure we do well and we are happy even before the results of the exams will come out, because we know that we've answered correctly the word. Not that we've studied, but we've answered correctly. The objective actually of this video is to ensure that we answer correctly, and I want to believe by the time we do justice to this, we will be glad we did. So Bengala, thank you from G James Associates. Don't forget to like us, subscribe, comment. Do you have any question? Please pass it on to us. We'll be readily available to answer your question. From G James Associates, we are value to life, we are value to your businesses.